It's that time of year again for the WWE Survivor Series pay-per-view coming up, I believe, on November 21st, so literally tomorrow. Well, it depends on when I upload this, but anyway, so I'm going to do one of my prediction videos. So just I'll give my usual warning, I guess you can say, is that I don't really watch Raw or SmackDown regularly, so I'm lucky I average about 5 minutes of Raw per month. If that's so, I'm not an expert. This is not really about that. It's about relaxation. But so don't take my predictions too seriously. Okay, let's get rolling here. All right, the first match is probably the most anticipated match of 2021. Of course, I'm talking about the 257.5 man battle royal matchup. My sources, however, tell me that it has been downgraded to a 25-man battle royal, which is probably a good idea. But I will read over the list of participants. Ricochet, T-Bar, Mansoor, Cesaro, Montez Ford, Angelo Dawkins, Eric and Ivar, R-Truth, Drew Gulak, AJ Styles, Omos, Sami Zayn, Humberto, Angel, Apollo Crews, Commander Aziz, Otis, Chad Gable, Shelton Benjamin, Cedric Alexander, Dolph Ziggler, Robert Roode, Jinder Mahal, and Shanky, or Shanky, I don't know how you pronounce that. So, I'm sorry, that was the wrong list. That was the list of people who got fired today. No, I'm just joking. Okay, yeah, so doing my Man Battle Royal. Actually, that's what they should do. Whoever wins is the only guy who doesn't get fired. But anyways, so I'm going to predict who I think is going to win this one. I don't know, bro. I mean, I'm looking at the list here. Okay, Ricochet. Yeah, probably not. Cesaro, maybe. And definitely the biggest name on the list is AJ Styles by far. But he doesn't really need this victory. Sami Zayn, maybe. And Omos, maybe as well. So my top two picks will be Omos and Sami Zayn. But definitely my number one pick would be Omos. Omos, if I'm saying his name right, I always forget. He has the most to gain. He needs a big win like this. No pun intended. And I think it would be really cool for him to win. And with AJ Styles, I hope he could do that. So I'm going with the big man, Omos, on this one. And should be interesting to see. I think it's going to be a good match. Like I said, most anticipated match of 2021. Alright, next up is my most anticipated match for 2021. It is Damian Priest versus Shinsuke Nakamura. And this is a champion versus championship match. Not championship match, but it's because Damian Priest is the United States champion, and Nakamura is the SmackDown Intercontinental champion. So I don't believe in these champion versus champion matches. The belts are on the line because that wouldn't make sense. It's just, you know, for bragging rights, as they say. But it should be interesting. And these are two good competitors. I think their styles will go together very well. I'm sure they've wrestled before. I just can't remember off the top of my head. Memory's not the greatest. Who's gonna win? I would have to pick, if I were to be judging in a most judgely way, I would say Donovan Priestley, who is also known as Damian Priest, is gonna win this one. I don't know. That's just the way I see it. He's got, I think, more momentum, I guess, is the word I'm looking for. So Donovan Priestley, for sure, is going to win this one, in my opinion. But let me know what you think. Alright, next up is the most anticipated match of 2021. I am, of course, talking about the Tag Team Champions versus Champions match, which is RK-Bro, which is Randy Orton, and Middle. Instead of Matt Riddle, it's called Middle. And they're the Rock Tag Team Champs. And of course, the Russos, Jimmy and Bimmy Uso. That's what I meant to say. Jimmy and Bimmy Uso. And Usos. It's really RK Broski and the Russos. Not RK Bro and the Usos. Sorry, I'm kind of rambling now. And they are the Usos are the Tag Team Champions. So it's another champion versus champions match, and well, I think it's going to be a good match. I've been betting against the team RK Bro a lot, to be honest, but they always keep winning. So, but I really like the Usos. I like the work with Roman Reigns. Everything is really good and cool about them. So I say he's gonna win this match. I'm gonna go with the Usos, although I have a feeling it's gonna come back to bite me, but I don't know. I have a feeling the Usos are gonna take it. And yeah, don't have too much more to add to that other than the fact that it'll probably be a pretty good match. Alright, so let's go to the next match. We have Big E, who was Raw's WWE champion, versus Roman Reigns. He's SmackDown's Universal Champion. And of course, he is with Paul Heyman. And this is another Champione versus Champione singles match. Now, I like both of these guys a lot. I'm really digging Roman Reigns' reign, so to speak, his heel run. It's been fantastic, fantastic work. I like his work with the Usos and all that stuff. But on the other hand, I also like Big E a lot too, loving him as champion. And this is a huge match, by the way. I'm really, I forgot to say this, but, you know, this is definitely going to be one of my most anticipated matches. My most anticipated match of 2021, that's for sure. Let me get that right. The most anticipated match of 2021. No, doot about it. Now, in terms of my prediction, I really think that Big E is gonna win this match. And I know that sounds crazy. I know, like, you know, Roman Reigns and all that, he's the, you know, being pushed to the moon and back. But since it's a non-title match, I think this is, you know, a way Roman can lose and, you know, not lose any belts or nothing. But, and you know, I think there's gonna be some shenanigans, some interference, some weird stuff's going on, but I don't see Reigns winning. I see Big Steve is gonna win this one. By the way, I'm just fooling around with the names a little bit, just to have a little bit of fun. Of course, when I say Big Steve, I mean Big E, of course. So yeah, Big E is gonna win this match, in my opinion. Of course, I could be totally wrong. Once again, let me know what you guys think in the comments, and I will read them. Okay, we're going through this pretty fast, so it's going to be a shorter than normal video. Next up is probably the most anticipated match in 2021. It is Becky Lynch, who is Raw's Women Champion, versus Charlotte Flair, who is SmackDown's Women Champion, in another champion versus champion matchup. So, I believe this is match 47 out of their feud so far. I don't really remember how many matches they've had and who's won how many and blah blah blah. I know there's that a while back there was the story that there's a lot of backstage the Charlotte Flair, and there's something about the belt, somebody throwing the belt or something like that. I don't know, but I just think that it's all BS. I think they're just making that up. I'm sure they should work to make people more interested in the match, to be honest. With that being said, who will and should win this match? For me, I think the answer to both of those questions would be Becky Lynch. I just think, it's Lynch's year. It's Lynch's match. And, I just think Big Time Rex is going to win the match. Barely there, Charlotte Flair. I just don't see it. I don't see the momentum. I don't see. But you know what? Who knows, right? And it's Charlotte Flair we're talking about here, so she seems to win everything. maybe she'll win the men's battle or the men's whatever match you do. She's gonna win all the matches. No, it happens from time to time. Okay, so yeah, going with Becky Lynch on that match. But with that out of the way, now we can finally get on to my most anticipated match of 2021. It will be the 5-on-5 Women's Survivor Series Elimination Chamber match. No, Elimination match. No chamber involved. So we got two teams here. Team Raw is Bianca Belair, Rhea Ripley, Liv Morgan, Carmella, and Queen Zelina. Versus Team SmackDown, Sasha Banks, Shayna Baszler, Shotzi, Natalya, and Toni Storm. So these are two very strong teams. I was trying to decide which team I think is a better team, and it's hard to say. I've flipped back and forth a few times on this subject. Bianca Belair is awesome. Rhea Ripley is awesome. Liv Morgan is, I wouldn't say awesome, but not bad either. She's kind of in the middle. I think Carmella's not awesome. She's kind of And Queen Zelina is not that great in my opinion, but it's just my opinion. Or I would say she's average at best, to put it that way. So you have two above average, one average, and two below average in my opinion. Wait, I didn't say that right, but anyways, I'm just gonna keep going. And then you have Team SmackDown, Sasha Banks, she's good. I like her a lot. Shayna Baszler, she's really good too. I like her a lot. So two strong wrestlers there. You got Shotzi. I don't know much about her, to be honest. Natalya, I'm just very tired of her. I mean, she's a good worker and all that, but I don't know. She's just been around forever and she's been doing the same old thing, you know what I mean? She needs to change it up somehow. And then you have Toni Storm, who's awesome too. So, and some, I don't know, it's just really hard to say which team is better. I'm kind of leaning toward the SmackDown team, but, I would have to predict that Team Raw is going to win. Yes, you heard it here, folks, Team Raw will win. Now, why do I think that? First, I actually picked Team SmackDown to win, because they're slightly better, but the fact that Queen Zelina is on Team Raw, I feel they want her team to win. It's not her team, but you know, she's on that team. So I'll pick Team Raw, and if I had to pick a sole survivor, which there's not necessarily just going to be one sole survivor, but if there is, it would be, man, that's hard to predict too. I don't know. Not Liv, not Carmella, maybe Queen Zelina. I don't know. Rhea Ripley, I guess I would pick. And finally, after all that, we get to the most anticipated match of the show and of 2021. It is the 5-on-5 Men's Survivor Series Elimination match. And we have Team Raw, which is Seth Rollins, Finn Balor, Kevin Owens, Bobby Lashley, and Austin Theory, with MVP, of course. And versus Team SmackDown, Drew McIntyre, Jeff Hardy, King Woods, Happy Corbin, and Sheamus, with Madcap Moss and Ridge Holland, which, I'll be honest, I don't even know who those guys are. It's all behind I am. So, who's a better team, first of all? See the Raw team yet again, but yeah, let's see, maybe the Raw team is a better team. Seth Rollins, you got Finn Balor, also known as Finn Balor, Kevin Owens, Bobby Lashley, I can't think of a funny name for him, but Austin Big Bang Theory, and with DVD in their corner. Team SmackDown, you got Johnny McIntosh, he's pretty strong, Jeff Hardy, King Woods, Happy Corbin, and Sheamus. So, I don't know, I kinda think the Team Raw is a stronger team. However, with that being said, I'm going to go with Team SmackDown to win it because, similarly to the Women's Survivor Series match, Team SmackDown has King Woods, and they probably want him to be on the winning team to further his success, to further his push, if you know what I mean. So that kind of makes sense. And in terms of who would be the sole survivor, if there is one, probably Woods, maybe Drew McIntyre. Those would be my guesses, but I'll just go with King Woods on that one. So definitely going to be the most anticipated match of the year. What do you guys think? Let me know your opinions. Let me know if you think I'm crazy, but just let me know, and I will read it in the comments. And I guess that wraps it up for this highly anticipated.